Well, this is a funny looking 3060 Ti. GTX 970. Okay. All right. Let's run with it. Let's have a little fun with this GPU here. Welcome to Machines & More. So no, I didn't get swindled with a 3060 Ti box. My brother got a 3060 Ti recently, so he was kind enough to lend me the old 970 for this test, and I love the 970. What an awesome card. And if you recall, this is the whole 3.5 gigabytes of VRAM versus the 4 gigabyte advertised fiasco a few years back. So GPU shortage or not, I love it when I see folks giving their older GPUs some TLC and being resourceful with what are still very competent components. And today we'll do just that with this card. Now it's really quite easy, but I'd like to document the difference that makes, and this will be the first video where we take a look at the impact of cleaning up old components. So I think he already made this card back in 2015, but nonetheless, it hasn't been repasted before. So this is kind of a nice test for us to see how a six-year-old GPU works. And this video has been 6 years in the making, basically, right? So I'll show you how to do that, and then we'll get into a quick before and after discussion here. So to start, you'll want to study the screws on the back of your graphics card PCB. You'll usually see a set of screws going through the back of this PCB and into the cooler, but sometimes there will be a few screws going into a back plate as well if you have one. So just make sure you can identify every screw that you can see and don't go and pry it off right away, because you'll probably snap something if you're not careful. Typically the ones that attach to the I/O shield on the PCB, you can leave alone. So unscrew the ones farther away from the perimeter of the GPU first on the outside of the card, and then finally loosen the screws around the GPU die slowly. And that's usually those four screws surrounding the center. And you'll see these are spring-loaded screws here. If your thermal paste is pretty much gone, that PCB will just come off super easily, just like you see on this one here. And yeah, this paste is in pretty poor shape. It's pretty dry and crumbly, although it does look like it was still making decent contact with the cooler plate. Now you can scrape off the stuff on the cooler, but then I carefully wipe the die surface and around it, and it will take a good bit of rubbing if your thermal paste is pretty old. And I am just using rubbing alcohol here with a blue shop towel. So absolutely make sure nothing falls on your die. These are quite fragile when exposed, but with some light elbow grease, you should be able to get nice and shiny. And yeah, there's a lot of dust on the PCB as well. It's not likely to affect anything right now, but it is nice to give it a wipe nonetheless while you're here. Lastly, go ahead and check the condition of the thermal pads. These are still soft and springy, but if yours are crumbling, then you will want to replace those as well. And that's usually pretty easy to do as long as you know what thickness you are dealing with and just cut that to size. So to reapply the paste, I'm not going with anything crazy here because I don't want to skew the results by using too good a paste. Arctic MX4 is reliable stuff, so just put a small amount on the die, and I'd spread it on very gently just to make sure you get a thin layer of even coverage. There's no need to overdo it. If you do go a little bit too much, it's not the end of the world. The mounting pressure will squeeze out what's unnecessary, but don't go too heavy-handed. So what thermal paste does is your two surfaces can be flat, but they won't mate perfectly. So thermal paste will bridge all those fine gaps and ensure proper contact. So with that done, go ahead and reverse the process. Make sure you tighten the screws around the die progressively, and then just make sure they are tight. Then tighten down the rest of the screws to the cooler. All right, six-year-old thermal paste. Does it make a big difference compared to fresh paste? I fired up a quick test to see what the impact was, and I just threw it into this Geek G1SE system, and I locked the fans at 50% and fired up a title that's still playable at 1440p with this card. And this is one my son and I really enjoy. Planet Zoo hits about 35 FPS in 1440p, and that's okay, not great, but still something that will get this card to 100% that is still playable. Well, before and after the thermal paste change, as you can see, there isn't a hugely significant difference between the two runs. I did check the clock frequencies for the card, and the card was reporting 1253 megahertz the entire time for both runs. So certainly the thermals are still good enough, and the card is still able to hit its highest stock boost clock for this particular edition. And FPS-wise, I didn't notice a significant difference. However, there is that odd spike and some variability. And in the long run, I think the repasted card is just a squeak better. But at least based on this test, 6-year-old thermal paste isn't going to kill your card's performance. I think EVGA did a good job here, but not all cards are the same. And that doesn't mean it's fine to keep going on with the old paste, because that's like saying you don't need to maintain your car since it's still drivable, right? And the paste will degrade to a point where the contact is seriously compromised. And then you will immediately see a big problem. And you'll notice that the temps spike whenever load is applied. If you have your fan set on a curve, that's the surefire sign that something is absolutely wrong, because they will ramp up to like 100% to no avail, since the die isn't transferring heat to the cooler effectively anymore. And if you do plan on overclocking your old car to get every mile out of it, like some people are doing right now, there's absolutely no way I would consider doing that with old paste. So the other thing I'd recommend doing, even though it's not necessarily bearing an important thermal impact, is just to blow the dust out of the card. And from a maintenance standpoint, it's good practice. And I think now this guy is good to last through another few GPU shortages. I don't think you have to repaste your card every year, but do check it every now and then. It's easy enough. And if you are concerned about those stupid warranty void stickers, which is a debatable issue depending on your locale and jurisdiction anyway, well, just wait until your warranty expires. I say typically a 2 or 3 year run on factory paste is perfectly fine, but for sure though, I wouldn't wait 6 years. So I hope that was helpful for you to get all that you can out of your card. A huge thumbs up to you if you are using an old card still. And hey, give a like if you enjoyed this video, and subscribe if you haven't already. And thanks for watching.